So we're here on the lake right now. What we're working on today is we got some ultra clear water, like really clear. It's a beautiful lake. It's about like 6:30. We got some vegetation all around the lake. It's perfect. Not that big of a lake, but yeah, we'll see how it goes.
So what happened here, pretty much, the GoPro got all messed up, the audio was messed up, everything else about the GoPro messed up, only got a little bit of footage, so.
We just got another fish to bite, came out of the water, just couldn't get the hook set. Now the memory is full on the little GoPro, so now we're just gonna have to stick to my phone. So, but, yeah, it came out of the water, destroyed it, just didn't get the hook set right, so. Hopefully we can get it back again. So the day's been pretty slow out here. We've gotten 3 fish to bite, the topwater frog, but just didn't get them hook set. Went wrong. So right now, I think we're gonna maybe go somewhere else, see if we can get any to bite over there, but hopefully we can get one in the boat today. So we caught the 4th one. Right at the edge of the boat, got him right up to the boat, broke off. It was a nice little pounder, but what can we do about it? Came off, so hopefully we can maybe get another one back for 5. So we're 1 for 3 today, but hopefully we can make that 2 for 3. So guys, just got home from the lake. Great day out on the water, I have to say. That was some incredible fishing. I've never fished like that before. So I just pretty much want to go over the whole day. So first thing in the morning, we got out on the lake, launched the boat. We just trolled over to this little spot on the lake. I can actually pull it up on my phone. So we just troll over. I saw that right in the morning. I wanted to head over there. Had the topwater frog on. So I knew it was going to be a great spot to fish. So we got over there, and I maybe 20 casts in, about 30 minutes out there, all of a sudden, boom, fish explodes on it. Go to do the hook set, pops right out of its mouth. Don't know what happens there. Real disappointment. So where we were, as you can see right here, is the boat launch. We went, I think it was right over here, you can actually see, because we were just in a drought. Well, we're still technically in the drought right now. So, like, these tule beds were out of the water. But now the water's, like, all the way up to here. So, here's the first one we hit. I got nothing. That's where I got that first bite. Then we hit it up to this one, and then I got the bite. Because you can see right in there, it's perfect for the bass to hide. Because there's a little, like, cove. So we hit there, hit that first spot, got that bite, and then we just trolled to the next one, got another bite. Fish came out of the water, just explodes on it, incredible. So then we headed up to the next one, nothing. Then we tried to go up this little channel, see if we get anything, just threw the frog on this little spot, tried to throw a little jig, didn't work. So then we headed back there, that spot, again. Then, we get there, do the same thing, cast out that same hole, because I knew that's the honey holder. There's got to be a fish there. Another fish comes flying out of the water, explodes on it. Go to do the hook set, pops out of its mouth again. So then, we go back to the dock. We need to get something. I think it was a fuel line, because the motor wasn't starting up that well. So then we headed up to some different tule patches, explored a little bit of the lake. Tried flipping and pitching a little bit, frogs, spinner baits, jerk baits, crank baits, nothing. So then I finally said, we're about to leave the lake, head home. It was about 1:20-ish. Then I say, let's head back over there, that bass. Hopefully it'll bite this time. Could have been a different one. Might be the same bass that those 2 other times. I'm pretty sure it was a bunch of different bass because it was stocked up in there. Head over there. 2nd time around. 3rd cast. Throw it in there. All of a sudden, tap, 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 tap. boom, fish explodes, and I get the hook set right. I'm reeling it in. It was a good pounder. I thought I could easily boat flip this one, bring it up, right on the edge of the boat, breaks off, takes my frog, a little fray in my line. Real disappointment for the day, but at least we got to see the show of the fish. So then we headed back to the boat dock, put the boat back on the trailer, and then packed up and left. So what I was using today, today, it's actually the next day, but what I used is I was using my Lewes Carbon Blue combo. It's the bait caster and the rod. They're both really good. It was I was using 12-pound monofilament. Everybody says when you throw on top water you should use braid, but I didn't, obviously. It still worked. My rod was a heavy medium. I like that really strong backbone to get me into the hook set on the frog. And then the little bit of a light tip so I can really twitch it. And then the lure I was using that caught all the fish. It was, knockoff brand of, like, some frogs. They're, like, really cheap. They're, like, $2. I just cut one of the tails. Well, the tails, little, like, hairs that come off. So, it'll help me work it a little bit better, and that really works, so. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more. Post every Monday. Like. Do all that kind of stuff. If you have any questions, comment in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.